Machine learning and AI, the hottest new things in tech. But if you're a business owner, you're probably wondering, how do I even use these things? Well, you're in the right place. Stay tuned. So you may have heard about AI or machine learning. What are these things and how can we use these things in our business? Well, before I get into exactly how you can use AI and machine learning in your business, let me define what machine learning and AI is. Machine learning is basically a branch of statistics applied to computer science. So if you have a lot of data, you can push that data through a machine learning algorithm and your machine, your computer, can start to uncover hidden patterns within that data. And thanks to academia and research, we have quite a few number of algorithms that can be used in everyday business applications. Before I get into the actual applications, I'm gonna give you the three categories of machine learning algorithms that you can deploy in your business. The first category is regression. Basically, what that means is if you have a random data point, a random data sample, how well does it fit into the overall trend of that data? So there are algorithms such as the linear regression, the multiple linear regression, polynomial regression, support vector regression, decision tree regression, random forest regression. Point is, there are a lot of regression algorithms to basically map out if a random data sample point fits well into the overall data. So let's start off with a simple regression example of how you can use regression in your business. So imagine that you have a sales force and you have two main variables. One is the number of people that you have in your sales force, the number of salespeople, and the second variable is that how many calls does each salesperson make. Now you want to see if there's a linear correlation between the number of salespeople and the number of calls that each person makes and how does that impact your revenue. This is where multiple linear regression can come in really handy because you have two variables, two independent variables. You have your number of salespeople and number two, you have the number of sales calls that each salesperson make and you have your dependent variable, which is your revenue. So what you would do is you would collect a lot of data. You know, you'd have 1, 2, 3, 4 salespeople. You'd make them, you know, do 10, 20, 30, 40 calls and you would see if there is some kind of correlation between number of salespeople and the number of sales calls that they make and your revenue. You would take that data, put it into a spreadsheet, and then put it into that machine learning algorithm, the multiple linear regression, and you should see some very surprising trends. So if your goal is to hit $10,000 in revenue for this month, that machine learning algorithm can basically tell you, hey, this is the set of configuration that you need. You need 10 salespeople making 50 sales calls each day, and that's how you'll most likely hit $10,000 per month. Machine learning can do that for you, specifically the multiple linear regression in this example. The second category is called classification. As the name suggests, classification basically means that you take any random data sample point and you basically want to classify it based on the variables that it has. So these would be algorithms such as the logistic regression, support vector machines, or K nearest neighbors. These algorithms can help you do that, and that is just a few algorithms. There are many more classification algorithms that you can use in your business. So let's start off with a really simple example that doesn't really have anything to do with business, but will give you the intuition behind how these classification algorithms work. Right here in my hand, I have a model of a Nissan GTR. But what if you wanted to classify it? What kind of vehicle is this? Is this a sports coupe, a sports sedan, a regular sedan, luxury sedan? What kind of car is this? So what you would start doing is finding some defining variables. For example, this car has two doors, has a huge spoiler on the back, quad tip exhaust, it has a 545 horsepower twin turbo V6. You know, a whole lot of things that you can find about this car. And from the description, it intuitively makes sense that the Nissan GTR is a sports coupe. But how do we tell that to a computer? How does the computer know that? How can the computer figure out that the Nissan GTR is a sports coupe and not just a regular coupe or a luxury sedan? How do we do that? Let me get into that explanation now. So if you think about it, what did we do? We defined some variables, the number of doors, the exhaust system, the spoiler, the engine, how much horsepower, and then we based that off of previous historical data of what we know intuitively about cars. So for example, we know that a luxury sedan usually doesn't have 545 horsepower, nor does it have only two doors, and most likely doesn't have a spoiler in the back with a quad tip exhaust system. just doesn't happen. So, most likely, we can rule out that the Nissan GT-R isn't a luxury sedan. That's basically what the machine does. It has some historical data, which it learns from, just how we have our historical data that we learn, you know, throughout time as we grow up. It does the exact same thing. It learns first. Then you would give the machine learning algorithm a new data point. For example, the Nissan GT-R. The machine learning algorithm doesn't really know, like, hey, this is a sports coupe, but you tell it the defining variables. The two doors, the quad sieve exhaust system, the spoiler, and the big super fat engine. And it will say, what other cars, based on my learning, had those defining variables, and what kind of car was it? And then it'll say, it's a sports coupe because that matches the defining variables of a sports coupe. There you go. Machine learned and then told you, based on historical data, what kind of car that is. So you're probably thinking, great. Now I know what a Nissan GT-R is and what kind of car it is, but how can I apply this to my business? So let's just jump right into a very practical example of how you can use classification to help better your business. Say you have three sets of customers and you have a different follow-up strategy for each one. Now, when you get a new customer, you're probably thinking, which category should I place this customer in? This is where classification can come in really handy. So if you have been defining the variables for each category, you can put that into a machine learning algorithm, and that algorithm will basically define what separates each category from each other. So when a new customer comes into your store and you want to classify them, the machine learning algorithm will say they have this gender, they have this age, they're from this part of town, they have bought this amount of stuff, it should go into category B, or maybe you'll say category C or category A. But it will tell you, most likely, which category that customer needs to be placed on based on the defining variables. And that's basically how you can use classification in your business. Classify things. And the third and final machine learning type of algorithm that can help your business out is called clustering. Clustering is tied back into classification, but the only main difference is you don't exactly know what categories you have, and you need help defining those categories before you can start placing things into categories. So let's just go with the example that we had for the last category of machine learning algorithm. Say that you have a business and you want to classify customers and have a different sales or follow-up strategy for each one. However, you don't really know which categories of customers that you have. It seems like a whole jumbled mess, and you have no way of knowing, you know, which kind of categories of customers do you have. This is where a clustering algorithm like K-means clustering can come in very handy. So again, you would have your defining variables such as age, gender, location, how much they have spent, and then you put that into the machine learning algorithm, and the algorithm will basically tell you what kind of categories or how many categories of customers do you have. And then it's up to you to figure out what kind of sales or follow-up strategy should you use with each category. Or for example, let's say you run an e-commerce store and you have a lot of data on your customers, but you don't know exactly what kind of customers do you have and how many types of customers do you have on your store. So you can use a clustering algorithm to basically figure out what kind of customers do you have on your e-commerce store and then try to service them better. This kind of insight on your business can mean night and day differences in your revenue and your customer experience and your customer retention. Let's say that there's an e-commerce store that doesn't use machine learning to classify what kind of customers that they have or cluster them into classifications. Now, they think that their customer experience or their customer service is great and all, but they don't really understand their customer. They don't know what kind of customers that they are bringing to their store. So they just deploy some generic customer service to all customers. And let's just say that that customer service isn't really the best type of customer service for their main type of customer. They are going to lose a lot of business. Now, let's say you're the smart cookie out of them all and you use machine learning algorithms to basically figure out, hey, I have three types of customers, so you can service them better and have personalized customer service and experience for each one. Not only will you drive more revenue, but your customer retention will go through the roof. You know, your branding will get better. Your marketing costs will, you know, plummet. It's just a great thing to have. And if you don't believe me and how machine learning can affect your business, then please tell me why the biggest corporations on the planet love using machine learning. For example, Apple Music, they're constantly clustering you into a specific category, classifying you into categories, and then recommending you new music That's what their algorithm does. And when their algorithm gets better, people are going to stay on that platform for longer because they're getting recommended good music that they like, and they will recommend that platform to other people as well, which will drive up Apple Music's revenue. So if you're telling me that machine learning isn't that important, well, I gotta break it to you. You're probably gonna be behind the curve and you're probably gonna get left behind. So, hands off, that's not my problem, that's yours. And plus, the beauty is that you can start stacking a bunch of algorithms together. So you can have a clustering, then a classification, then a regression, all into this big, huge machine learning algorithm that you incorporate into your business and apply to your business. You will be miles ahead of the competition. While your competition is shooting in the dark trying to figure out how can I better serve my customer, you are out there gathering data, analyzing the trends, and then based on the trends and empirical data, you are making logical decisions to better serve your customer. You see where I'm trying to get at? You're way ahead of the competition when you're gathering data and you're using machine learning to better serve your customer. It's insane. Machine learning is changing how business runs. So if you have any questions about machine learning and how it can help your business, or if you want a free consultation of how machine learning can be applied to your business, I'll have some social media links down below popping up right now, which you can contact me at, or my email at ishi.singh@gmail.com. Let's get to talking. Let's get jiggy with it. So if you're all hyped up about machine learning and AI, hit the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you know exactly when content drops. Because here on this channel, we like to work smart, not just work hard. Remember, work smart and work hard, you're about to blow out your competition. And as always, it's your boy Sunny Chopper. Peace. Percocet, Miley Percocet.